time you ever have, boy.
Sci-fi until the day we die.
Get back! Get down! Get ready! Book on face!
Expended.
Power is an acronym that stands for people organized and working for economic rebirth.
The nice guys don't have any power.
You have to recognize that with increasing power comes increasing responsibilities.
Power at its best is love.
We do not believe, sir, that black people should continue to depend on whites to do for us what we should be doing for ourselves. Power.
Power, the people say, that power without love is reckless and abusive, and that love without power is sentimental and anemic.
Power. I think in the role of a teacher, we believe that a lot of the responsibility must rest firmly on our own shoulders.
The mechanics.
Power. We should turn that production power back into our own hands, build our own schools, our own factories, employ our own people. This would make us stronger black people. It would make us stronger America if blacks were allowed to do so. Power.
The United States arrives at its power in part by restraining itself.
1-800-43-POWER.
All right.
I would hope that you all would call it.
Yeah.
Power.
It would preclude me to believe that these brothers, if initiated into Gamma Epsilon, it had to have happened before January 19, 1947, right?
Yeah.
Would it have happened in 46?
Oh yeah, I thought that they began in 46.
The spring of 46, okay.
The activities in the spring of 46.
Okay, yeah, I see it right here. Professor Burke of the English Department, Professor Mosley of the Industrious Arts were agreeable to sponsor. These activities took place in the spring of 47. Then you went out to solicit and recruit potential members of the first fraternity chapter at Hampton. And then this is where the seven initiated members were identified.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. These activities all took place in 46.
Okay.
And then Burke certified what was going on with the next group.
Okay. Got it. The seven initial members came together in 46.
But then were official in 47. So they started in 46.
By the time this is written, we had added an additional member.
Right.
Okay.
There were seven initial members: William Purney, Burrell Ellis, Tom Casey, John Bell, Alfonso Knight, Warren Gardner, and Tom Sims were the seven initial members that Brother Haywood ushered into Omega Psi Phi.
They all had to go through become Omegas by standard procedure. There was a small number deliberately. The whole purpose was to go through all the procedures, make sure the system was working properly. And then you would have somebody who could carry out a normal initiation.
And then there was these group of men who followed thereafter. And then it sounds like there was yet a second group of men.
So to get to 27, we started with the first,
seven. And then there was a second wave.
15 and 7 is 22. So another five. 27.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen. Do it, screams from the haters.
In the initial phases of Gamma Epsilon, several axioms were set in motion in order to ensure the growth and prosperity of the chapter. Brother Julian Hayward, a new transfer student from Howard, one of the few Omega Men and fraternity undergraduate students on the campus of Hampton Institute, seized an opportunity to make history. After recruiting a small group of the best and brightest, seven distinguished gentlemen on Hampton's campus, Brother Hayward began the facilitation of new initiates into the newly proposed chapter of Omega Psi Phi fraternity at the campus of then Hampton Institute. They came together in groups, first starting with the initial seven that helped bring along the remaining brothers. Brothers Kearney, Ellis, Casey, Bell, Knight, Sims, and Gardner are the seven that started their process in the fall of 1946 and finished in January of 1947. But since the chapter had no official charter yet, they were still considered lamps. These seven lamps helped Brother Hayward usher through the remaining brothers that makes up, in Brother Hayward's words, the initial charter line of Gamma Epsilon. In the spring of 1947, although the charter was not given to the chapter until February the 12th, 1947, the first initial seven and others are on record with IHQ as being initiated on January 22nd, 1947, followed by more in April, and then even more in the fall of that same year.
The distinction isn't worth because it gives an exclusion to other people.
Right.
That's why I said, everybody that was a member in 47,
yeah,
I believe, should just be called a charter member.
Gotcha.
Right, understand.
Because the first group,
yeah,
it wasn't a full chapter. It hadn't gone through all the procedures.
Got it.
The 15 more was added, and that's how it went.
Yeah. But I do want to ask you the question, Brother Hodges, about being part of really this group of men who were selected to become part of the Lampados Club in 1947. What was your interest in Omega? What inspired you to become part of this organization?
One of the main impetuses for me to become a Q was this other student who was a Q and whom had been my high school classmate. That was probably had more weight than anything else.
Mm-hmm.
And I've never been sorry that I did right.
Right, no, that's a beautiful thing to hear. But was there any activity that took place before the official pledge period began that enabled to brothers to interact with the potential interested men?
Yes. When we were, they had an initiation for the Lampada's Club.
Okay. So that was an official process in
that
itself.
That was an official process.
Okay.
And the brothers, while we were in the Lampada's Club as pledges and before the initiation process, they treated us just like we were brothers, just like we were kings, you know? They were so good to us, you couldn't believe it.
What was the fraternity about?
Right.
It wasn't about this year or there. It was an overall principle of getting guys together who had like purposes.
Yes.
And similar goals.
Yes.
And being successful.
Yeah.
Every one of those guys on this picture had some measure of success later on.
In their life, that's awesome.
Best right. I can tell.
Right, right.
That's what we were after.
We had an official initiation into the Lampardis Club, and I was under the impression that I was already a member. Until Hell Week started.
Okay. So that impression changed.
Yeah.
So did it change for you during Hell Week, or did it change for you when the initiation process, the pledge process began?
No, it changed during Hell Week.
During Hell Week, okay.
But from initiation in the Lampardis Club up until Hell Week.
Yes.
Oh, we were the greatest guys on earth as far as the brothers were concerned.
Okay.
They did everything for us what we wanted.
Wow. So.
And then when Hell Week started, it was like, are these the same people that we knew last week?
Right.
You know?
Yeah. I'm better understanding your point, Brother Haywood, with regards to attracting men who had similar interests, men who had characteristics that would lead them on to be successful. It was about those men coming together and forming a union. It sounds like that was really the embodiment of the process up to the point in which we then enter into the Hell Week, where all of a sudden there was this change of roles and guard, so to speak. What was the purpose behind Hell Week? And
why are you asking me to say that? You're talking now about traditions.
During that time, and we call it a line, where men would literally line up and then parade around the campus under the guidance and direction of the brothers that were part of that chapter. Did the initiation period happen that way back in 1947?
Yes, it did. We had, it seems like it was a 2-week period. I don't recall really what it was or not. And we had to carry our lanterns
through
that entire period.
Okay.
And we had to do one program of some sort in the yard.
Okay.
You understand what I mean?
I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
Yes.
In the yard. And what we did was we had a ball game with no balls or no bats.
Right.
You know, guys being put out and running and all that stuff.
Sure.
It came out pretty good.
Uh-huh.
Came out pretty good.
That was your program.
That was our program for the public.
Right.
And then we did something else. For the chapter itself, I've forgotten what that was.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I see down here, one of the questions you had was, did we step in those days?
Right.
We did some shouting and, you know, and singing of one song, giving that old Omega spirit or something like that. And we did serenade. Remember, and I think that was during the time that we were pledging our pledge group went and serenaded the women. I had forgotten all about that.
Yeah, but there was some stepping, it sounds like. Well, less so stepping, more serenading.
No
stepping.
No stepping. We would do shouting and jumping.
Okay.
But there really was
no formal stepping. No organized stepping.
He'd do what was good for just and love. It's good enough for me. Give me that Omega Spirit. Give me that Omega Spirit. Give me that Omega Spirit. It's good enough for me. He'd do what's good for Cooper and Coleman. It was good for Cooper and Coleman. It was good for Cooper and Coleman. It's good enough for me.
What was your process for selecting the first line, and how did you go about weeding out the prospective men for the chapter?
As I indicated, I was busy trying to get into medical school. And I'd also just come from Howard University, where I had been selected out of a group of scholars who were there to study medicine and engineering. And so I looked for people who seemed to be serious, capable, and to have character. There's that unspoken quality that you know when you meet someone, that these individuals have something about them that make them want to succeed. And that's what I look for in choosing fellow members of the first chapter at Hampton Institute. And so, look what happened. You're all evidence that that approach succeeded.
So we had a way you never tell. You decide if darkness knows you well. That lesson of love, all that it was, I need you to see. You got that power over me. My mind, everything I hold dear resides in those eyes. You got that power over me. My mind, the only one I know, the only one on my mind. You got that power.